Hello everyone. Welcome to the 16th video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. After completing a composition or project in After Effects, you can export a movie file. So in this video, you will learn these topics. 1. Exporting a video in MP4 format. 2. Exporting a video without a background. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. In the previous tutorial, we created this simple animation, and now we export the same animation. First, pay attention to the duration of the composition. As you can see, the duration of this composition is 10 seconds, but the duration of the workspace shows 4 and 16 seconds. Actually, by changing the work area, we determine the duration of export of the composition. Also, by changing the position of the time indicator and pressing the end button, we can change the duration of the work area. To change the duration of the composition, you can also right-click on the composition and select the composition settings option. Now you can change all the composition settings. After determining the duration of the composition, click on the main composition of the project or select the timeline panel. Now, from the main menu, select Composition and then Add to Render Queue. The good news is that in After Effects 2023, MP4 or H264 format has been added to this program, and there is no need to install additional programs. After selecting the Add to Render Queue option, you will see that the Render Queue panel is opened at the bottom. The Render Queue panel includes three main sections: Render Settings, Output Module, and Output 2. To check the rendering settings, I click on the best setting option. In the quality section, we select the best option. In the resolution section, we can choose full, half, third, and quarter options. Here you can see the original resolution size and the selected resolution size. I choose the full option. In this section, the composition frame rate value is written, and by selecting this option, we can change the frame rate value. I choose the original frame rate of the composition. The time span option determines whether to export the duration of the work area or the total duration of the composition. At the beginning of this video, I explained this. If I select the work area option, the export duration becomes 4:16 seconds, and if I select the length of comp option, the export duration changes to 10 seconds. The start and end time of the composition is also written, and if we click on the custom option, we can change the start, end, and duration of the composition. I select the work area option. Other options in this section do not need to be changed. I click on the OK button. Now I click on the option that is placed in front of the output module. In this window, we determine the format for exporting the composition. As I said at the beginning of the training, in the version 2023 and later After Effects, H264 or MP4 format has been added to the After Effects, which has good quality and reduces the video size. There are other formats here, for example, by choosing the PNG format, the composition will be exported as consecutive photos. We also use the QuickTime format for exporting compositions without background, which we will discuss in the rest of this video. I choose RGB from the Channels section. I click on Format Options. Encoding setting is very important because this section allows you to determine at what speed your video will be exported. Hardware encoders tend to perform better than software encoders because they shift the workload from the CPU to a specialized component on the GPU that can encode the video more efficiently. I select Hardware Encoders. There are two modes for bitrate encoding. Select CBR for fixed bitrate and VBR for variable bitrate. I choose VBR. As expected, a higher bitrate improves video quality, but also increases the size of your video. This choice is entirely up to you. I increase its value to 50. If only software encoding is available for you, set the target bitrate to 20 and the maximum bitrate to 50. You can also increase the audio bitrate in the audio section. Finally, I click on OK. By activating the resize option, you can change the size of the video again. The crop option allows you to crop a part of the video. Usually, we do not need to change these options. I click on OK. In front of Output 2, I click on the name of the composition and choose the place to save the video. From here you can change the name of the file, and if you activate the Save and Subfolder option, the file will be placed in a folder after export. Finally, I click on the Save option and then click on the Render option. It will take some time to export the file, it depends on the size of the composition and your system. In this way, the video will be created in MP4 format. I will return to the composition. Many times we need to export a video without background to combine it with other videos. To do this, click again on the main composition of the project or select the timeline panel. From the main menu, select composition and then add to render queue. Click on this option in front of the output module. In the format section, select QuickTime. After the channels section, select the RGB plus alpha option. Click on Format Options. Select the Animation option from the Video Codec section and click OK. In front of Output 2, I click on the name of the composition and choose the place to save the video. Here you can change the name of the file. Finally, I click on the Save option and then click on the Render option. In this way, a video without background is exported. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I'll see you next time.